In this video, we will discuss the effect of serum potassium in the electrocardiogram. Hypokalemia is defined as serum potassium less than 3.5 milliequivalents per liter. Moderate hypokalemia is defined as serum potassium less than 3 milliequivalents per liter. And severe hypokalemia is defined as serum potassium less than 2.5 milliequivalent per liter. The first ECG change in mild hypokalemia is flattening of T wave or T wave inversion. Moderate hypokalemia causes mild ST depression, QT prolongation, visible U wave, and ventricular extrasystoles. It should be noted that U waves are often best seen in the mid-precordial leads, that is V2, V3 and V4. Severe hypokalemia, that is when serum potassium level is less than 2.5 milliequivalents per liter, it causes torsade de pointe and ventricular fibrillation. Hyperkalemia is defined as serum potassium concentration greater than 5.5 milliequivalents per liter. The earliest sign of hyperkalemia in ECG is narrowing and peaking of the T wave. It is called tenting of T wave. This tenting of T wave should not be confused with hyperacute T wave seen in acute myocardial ischemia. In hyperacute T wave, the base is broad, the tip is not pointed, and usually it is associated with ST segment elevation. As the serum potassium further rises, there is diminution or loss of P wave. There is prolongation of PR interval, and there is widening of QRS complex. And any kind of conduction block can occur. When hyperkalemia is very severe, the widened QRS complexes merge with the corresponding T waves and the ECG looks like sine wave pattern. If potassium further rises, the heart arrests in asystole. So if you carefully observe, hypokalemia causes T wave inversion and hyperkalemia causes T wave to peak. Hypokalemia and hyperkalemia should be treated promptly to avoid these cardiac events. Hope this video was useful and see you soon in the next video.